What's up, everybody? For the win, Itachi, back at it again with another Poke Vlog brought to you by a YouTube channel of youtube.com/ForTheWinItachi. We are about to hit up three different parks today. Two of them are new. One is the OG park of Central Park. We are right now at Heritage Park, and there is a Mystic Gym. Sorry about the wind, but we got to do what we got to do. It is an oversized soccer ball. Number two is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's six of them here. As you guys can see, there's the oversized soccer balls. Two soccer fields, one's on that side and one's on this side. But yeah, we basically got a gym here that is taken over by Team Mystic. Got a really bad Arbok, an average Vaporeon, an Arcanine, as well as a Dragonite. So Team Mystic is holding this gym down. Sadly, I will be able to take care of this, hopefully. But first, I'm going to go ahead and grab these three Pokestops. One is way in front of me, not sure what that is. But these other two over here, it's probably the entrance to the park as well as the park itself. So let's go ahead and get the farthest one out of the way first, and I'll meet you guys there. All right, now that we're getting close to this Pokestop, might as well bring you guys back into the action. We're going to go ahead and click on this. I'll show you guys where my egg situation is right now. I do have currently six eggs, so hopefully we can get two more, and hopefully out of those two, one is a 10K. Again, I do not have that many Pokecoins on me right now, and I refuse to spend the in-game money at this point in time, so hopefully I can take some gyms. And the reason why I refuse is I really don't have that much money to spend on me at the moment. But that will be a different story. I do have one egg that is 1.7 out of 2, and we'll be able to hatch that definitely today, as well as get some more eggs, hopefully. So we are at this Pokestop. It is the San Francisco Creek Trail. Go ahead and do a little quick spinneroo. We did get an egg. Oh, wow, we got a lot out of that one. We did end up getting an egg out of that, so let's go ahead and check it out. What was it? Go to Pokemon, and then we're going to go ahead and check on eggs. And it is a 5K egg, and sadly, I don't have any more incubators. I only have six on me, and I do not have enough Pokecoins. However, there is a Pidgeot in the area. So let's go ahead and see if we can find the Pidgeot. If it's a Pidgeotto, that's okay as well. And then, of course, we got three Rattatats and female Nidoran Paris, two Pidgeys, and a Spearow. But those aren't going to be in nearby anytime soon. There is no other Pokestops except those two, so we're going to go ahead and walk all the way back to the other side. It is towards the park area itself, and it's also towards the entrance to the park, so I'm assuming that's what both of those Pokestops are. So we're about to hit these two Pokestops up. Oh, we just got something that spawned on the screen. It is nothing too great. It is a Spearow. Just got two Rattatatas just before this. Both very low CP. I believe one was 10 and one was 15, so that wasn't very good. But we're about to get these two Pokestops in. There's a couple of Pokestops across the street, but we will not be making our way over there. We will be making our way over to another park, which is called Bridgeport Park. And it isn't too far away from here, but we are at Heritage right now. I am gonna go actually train a little bit with some soccer by myself, get my workout in, and then we'll go ahead and head on over to the other park. So I'm gonna go ahead and get these Pokestops in, get some training in, and then I'm gonna go ahead and make my way over to the other park after we get these Pokestops in one more time. This Spearow is causing me some wow. Really, bro? Really, Brody? You're just gonna run away and do me in like that? All right, let's get, yep, I called it, entrance to the park. We got some Pokeballs out of that one. And we're also very close to this one as well, I believe. Oh, here we go. Bad boy of all bad boys. It's a 2K egg though, so hopefully we can get one of the starters. That's all we're going for here. It is Jigglypuff out of a 2K egg. I think we can evolve. We can fucking evolve, son. To 511, oh. Do me dirty, son. We can evolve a Jigglypuff, and I'm gonna hold off on another egg. What? I know I was not close to hatching another egg. This is some serious stuff. This is a 2K egg. The other one was a 5K. That makes sense now. We got a Weedle, which is pretty damn decent. Hopefully we can get enough candies, because I do want a Beedrill pretty soon. Go ahead and get this Pokestop in, get a little Spinaroo. Team Valor has that gym up there. Let's go ahead and see what's cooking. Go see what's cooking. Again, like I said, there's some Pokestops and another gym across the street, but I'm not going to be going over there. This, however, is within the park, and I know that for a fact. It is actually pretty close to some houses. The level 3 gym with an Electabuzz, Arcanine, and Flareon. So we got Mystic and Valor owning it up over here, but we are not going to do too much at this park. It is kind of empty and dull, but it is a nice, easy park to go ahead and have some fun at, especially with two gyms and three Pokestops. So I might make my way over here some more, but I'm definitely not going to be battling some gyms right now. My goal for this video is to hopefully, I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys, my bad, I did not mean to click on Pokemon, is to show you guys really quickly on my Pokédex. I'm trying to collect as many Pokemon as possible. As you guys all know, the goal is to catch them all. I have 100 and, what do I have right now? I have 108 and I've seen 109. The next Pokemon I am going for is on the bottom, and I believe it is Porygon, if it's 135 or something like that, 137, and that is Porygon, so I'm going for Porygon. Of course I'm going for, I cannot get 144, 45, and 46, those are Zapdos, Moltres, and Articuno, but I would like to get Dragonair and Dragonite, which is 148 and 149, but I'm really going for 137, which is Porygon, so hopefully we can hatch one in an egg. That is my pretty much only option I can at this moment, and it is a 5k egg, but it is very rare, so hopefully we can hatch one. That is my next goal, and that's the next Pokemon we're going through, and hopefully we can get them soon. Alrighty, everybody, we made it to the second park of the day. We're about to get a Cubone, trashy Cubone at that. It's a CP40, but I'll take any candies. We're not really here for the park. We're actually here for some decent Pokemon to capture, as well as a gym. And let's go ahead and check out what the gym is controlled by at the moment after we get through this Cubone action. There's really nothing to do at the park, which is behind me, but all in front of me there's this little community, and it has water going through it, so it's very awesome scenery as well. So Valor does control it, and there only seems to be two Pokemon in here, so let's go ahead and add a third. But I need to find the, I think I found the correct path on order to walk through this community. I've done it once before, but it was that really pitch black at night, so it was really hard to see. We got a Pidgey though here. And there's, again, there's usually a lot of Pokemon to capture here, which is really cool, but they're not great Pokemon, but there is a possibility of some rare Pokemon. I've seen Alakazam here, but sadly it was the day after PokeVision got disbanded, or not disbanded, but they can't really do anything anymore, and we weren't able to find that Alakazam. And I felt really bad that day, but it's all goo. We're gonna go ahead and get this Pidgey in the ball. Gonna go ahead and do a nice little walk, and we'll walk back and forth to the gym and back, and then we'll head on over to the last park. But the only reason why I'm here is scenery wise, and again, a chance to catch some cool Pokemon. And the best Pokemon that I've got on my nearby list right now is a Magikarp. So let's get some candies on our Magikarp glory adventures, and let's go ahead and drop a Pokemon onto this gym. And while we're at it, I'll give you guys some cool sceneries. Thank you. get some gym action in on this video, but not a whole lot. Our goal is that Porygon, so we're just walking them KMs right now. Where the mileage. We got a Dodrio. I always told you, there's something very special here all the time. And we are gonna get a Paris instead. That's okay, though. We will try to capture this. Oh, no, it's a Pidgey. God damn, I can't even see. That's how blind I am right now, guys. You know what? Let's go ahead and get into the shade so I can actually see myself in the cameras. Let's get more into the shade. There we go. I caught Pidgey on the first try anyways. That's fine. That's fine and all. And there is a Paris there, so I wasn't blind. It was just two spawns on one. Let's go ahead and focus on this Paris. So it is a 109. I was able to barely scrape it, but we were able to get it into this Pokeball. I guess not. I guess he's just been pretty damn mean today. I wish I had a gym this close to my house. I would have it every single day. It wouldn't leave my sight. Sadly, I live in a... Oh, really? Really, bro? Really, bro? You gonna do me like that? Paris gonna do me like that, man. Really, man? I'm really a Paris? At a CP of 109, I have a Paris sect. A super duper high CP. We still got that Dodrio on the list as well as the Magikarp, but let's go ahead and get closer to this gym so we can drop in one of our Pokemon, keep this gym with Team Valor for quite some time, and should be able to drop in and let it begin. Who are we gonna drop in though? We gotta go ahead and switch to CP. First off, let's check what's in here. We do got a Slowbro and a Vaporeon, so they're going pure water right now. I'm gonna mix this up. I'm gonna drop in my Arcanine for the win. We're just gonna go all out with Arcanine, and I should have control of this gym myself due to my CP being super duper high on the 1692 side. So we do have it on our own squad, and we do have a Raticate as well as a Dodrio on our list. So let's go ahead and see if I have them already. But let's go ahead and see if we can find these guys before we head on over to the last park of the day. Just as I said that, right next to the gym, guys, there is the Dodrio. So we're gonna go ahead and head on back out. It is a CP 292, so I'm not even gonna waste a Great Ball, Raspberry, or anything on it. It's a pretty bad Dodrio, but I'm pretty bad at throwing these Pokeballs, so we're gonna two-hand this. Barely scraped it, but that's okay. That's okay. Let's go ahead and give you guys a nice little view in the background. Boom, boom, boom. And we got it right away. I mean, that's pretty sad. There's a CP 292 Dodrio, but we're gonna probably trash it anyways because I got a Dodrio that's much better than that. Tons of Pidgeys and Rattatats in the area. There's a Raticate and a Magikarp, but I have no idea where they are, and I'm not walking any farther that way. So we're gonna go ahead and check out the Pokeballs really quickly here. I mean, not the Pokeballs, the eggs. And we've got a couple that are very close to hatching. And let's go ahead and make sure they do hatch. But for now, let's go ahead and head on over to the car. There is no Pokestops in this area. There is a couple, but they're out of my way. And I'm not going to go ahead and go out of my way to go get them, because there are going to be plenty of Pokestops and plenty to do at this next park. As you guys know, OG Park of OGs, Central Park of Santa Clarita. We started off at Heritage, went to Bridgeport. Now we're going to Central Park. And throughout this video, again, I'm trying to hatch as many eggs as possible because I believe that is my best opportunity to hatch a 5K egg in order to get my next Pokemon on the Pokedex Licks, which is a Porygon. So hopefully we can get Porygon soon. That would be great. Everybody, as you guys know, I just took that gym over here. Let me go ahead and spin around to it. Where is it? Way back in the background over there. I'm gonna go ahead and click on it. As you guys know, I took over this gym. I dropped in my 1692 Arcanine. However, there is a gym right next to me, and it seems it's a high level. It's a decent enough level, but I believe it is an easy gym to take. It is a Team Mystic gym right now. But we are going to go ahead and get some Pokemon ready for ownage here. It is level 6. It's got a 470 Raticate, 499 Bellsprout, 617 Rhydon, 1107 Venusaur, as well as 1168 Arcanine. So this shouldn't be too hard to take over. We're going to go ahead and do so really quick. It is a level 6 though, so it's going to take a couple of battles. But let's go ahead and
get into the action. We are going to use a decent amount of Pokemon here. I'm going to go ahead and start off. Well, first of all, let's check it out. What do they got? Got normal type, grass type, so I can use. And then they got ground, grass, and fire. So I'm going to use my water types for later. My Vaporeon's last. My Amisar's second to last. We do got a normal type to worry about. We're going to use our Exeggutor third to last. Our Rhydon can go first, Snorlax second, and I'm going to throw in Pidgeot there. And I believe that is a decent enough team. And in fact, let's just make this really easy, throw in Jolteon. So I believe that is it. Jolteon, Snorlax, Pidgeot, Exeggutor, Amisar, and Vaporeon. That is our top six. So let's go ahead and use them. And this should be an easy takeover. I believe it is. They don't have too many high CP Pokemon here. We should be able to get into this battle, hopefully. Most gyms do take quite some time to get into. Here we go. Jolteon against Raticate. Electric type moves are not amazing, but it is a 1207 Jolteon against a 478 Jolteon, so we should be fine. And it is almost done. I mean, Raticate, 478 is done, so Jolteon did do the job that it needed to do, but now we're going against a Bellsprout, and it's not very effective because Bellsprout is, if you guys remember, against that very first season of Pokemon, Ash had to face off against a Bellsprout, and he had to defeat it with a Muk. I'm definitely switching Pokemon. He had to defeat it with a Muk, and he had to go through some trouble. His Pikachu wasn't doing any damage. All Bellsprout had to do was drop the roots underneath itself in order to protect itself from electric-type attacks. It was absolutely immune to electric-type attacks, but this is okay because Amisar is doing in and putting in work against Rhydon, so we Gucci against Rhydon as well. We're going to go ahead and do another switcheroo into Pidgeot this time. Pidgeot is super effective. It is flying type against a grass type. Pidgeot is super effective against a grass type. So we're going to go ahead and get Pidgeot's ultra ability out as soon as possible. And I'm not too sure on which one this is. What is his super ability? Here we go. It is Hurricane. Oh, it is a definite destruction right there. Venusaur just got the D taken away. And let's go ahead and do one more switcheroo into Vaporeon. We're not even going to lose one Pokemon here. Vaporeon's going to absolutely annihilate this Arcanine. And this is going to be a quick gym destruction. Again, it is level 6 gym. And I am taking it out with ease right now. This Arcanine is going to be completely destroyed. And we're going to take this gym over, as well as the one back there that I've already taken over. So that's going to be two gyms at one park. And that is an amazing amount of prestige that we just dropped off. So it is level 5, and we're going to go ahead and continue back at it. But for now, let's go ahead and keep on the fighting. This is going to be the final battle, and we are going to end this off with our Golduck going up first. The reason being is I want my Snorlax to have that health points so I can go ahead and rape him into this gym. Our gold duck is at 1135 while the arcane app. Put your goddamn fucking goddamn Harley shit off. Fucking hate those bites. You guys saw the rage. Sick of those bites, man. But my gold, what does he know? What is his moves? Oh, fuck. Is he even a water type gold duck? Oh, he knows ice beam. Fuck no, he only knows ice beam. All right, well, at least Kabutops came in for the rescue. This should be the last battle. We dropped him from level 6 all the way down to 0. We got to get that prestige down, and it should be done. It is done. There's currently no team here anymore. So let's go ahead and make it for Team Valor. Going to go ahead and drop in the squad. The biggest squad of all times. And we've got it. Got both gyms in the area, I believe, still. Hopefully no one's taking my other gym. It is a level 2 gym now. 1900 Snorlax. Not going to last too long. And over here, I should have that other gym. There's an Ekans. Get out of my way. Let me go ahead and click on it in the background. We should have both gyms at this park now. Again, yeah, we do have this one. My Arcanine's in that one. So my top 2 strongest Pokemon are in the game. We do got a Fearow and a Bulbasaur and an Eevee pretty close by. But let's go ahead and get this Ekans really quickly. It is a CP73 Ekans. I'm actually going to go see if we can find this Bulbasaur before we head off onto the last park. And the reason being is I would love a Bulbasaur right now. I do not have an Ivysaur yet, and it would be really good to get those candies out of the way and hopefully evolve one of my Bulbasaurs to an Ivysaur, depending on if we can get enough candies pretty soon. I'm going to go ahead and make a quick walk and see if I can find it. If I don't find him shortly, he's probably going to despawn. So we got a Fearow, an Eevee, as well as a Bulbasaur. So let's go ahead and see if we can find it. Just got to the park, and I did not want to let this one go. It was a Clefairy, and it was a high CP too, which was pretty damn good. CP was 473. That's high for me. And we're going to go ahead and just start raking in these Pokestops here. Not too much to do here unless we get some cool Pokemon, but nothing on my nearby list right now. So hopefully some lures and hopefully some incenses can attract some good Pokemon here. But I did just grab this Pokestop right next to me, and I just got my last egg, and it is a 2K. So sadly, hopefully we can start knocking out some of these 5Ks again. Porygon is the goal right now, and we're going to go ahead and just walk around, gather as many Pokestops as possible, and egg it up. And again, we're just walking around. Hopefully we can get that Porygon today. Let's go ahead and make sure we get that in really quick. And I did say I was not going to do any gym annihilation today. As you guys already know, I've taken over those 2 gyms at Bridgeport. Looks like I'm going to have to take these gyms over as well. Oh, the Sonics ain't too bad. We got to concentrate. Got to concentrate. Oh my gosh. Oh no. This isn't concentrating. I'm wasting Pokeballs right now, son. Did that even reach? Didn't even reach. Oh my gosh, stop attacking. This can't be real. Oh my gosh. This is not real. Look at this. He jumps, he attacks. How is Onyx so hard to finally. There we go. I want to take this gym over. It's level 1 before anyone on Mystic starts. You joking, bro? I'm not wasting anything else on you. There we go. That was actually a pretty damn decent throw. So I'm very happy. 2 good throws in a row. Now that one actually gave me the great signal. So it's a great signal. You know what that means. It is not go. Looking like an idiot over here. Pre-dancing. Oh! New level. Oh my gosh. That throw is just, it's begging. Begging for Pokeballs to be thrown at its face right now, man. I'm throwing all these balls at the face. Come on. Look at this. This is pathetic. My phone's getting sticky because of my fingerprints, and it's just getting worse. It's getting worse by the second, man. Onyx, I didn't even want you, man. I didn't even want you. I'm just capturing you because you're higher CP than the one I've got. Oh, this is pathetic. Oh no. I'm almost under 100 Pokeballs. Oh, please. Please. Come on. 2. Fuck. I'm under 100 Pokeballs. Maybe not. This might be just the one that I needed. Almost there. I'm sweating. Oh no. Alright, fine.
I'm under 100 Pokeballs. I'm not going under 40 Great Balls. Oh, god damn it. If you can throw like that, then life itself is over. That, see, another nice throw. Are we actually going to get this so I can take over the gym today or no? I want to take over the gym today. Oh my gosh. Stop doing this to me, dude. I'm not throwing a raspberry at you. You're not hungry. I don't need to feed rocks. Give me this Pokemon so I can take over the gym. Come on, son. I'm under, that was 40. Let's go ahead and Ultra Ball it then. I'm not going under 70 Ultra Balls. Oh my gosh, just wasted one. Wasn't looking at him. I was focusing on my throw. This guy's jumping. This guy's in a bouncy cancel right now, man. He's going all over the place. Look at this. He won't even let me throw. All right, let's concentrate. Here we go. Are you joking? I already threw it and then you attacked. There we go. Circle was as big as right now. Give it. I don't even want it. I don't even want it. Oh man, I big thumbed that one. Oh, come on, I'm throwing the phone. If I don't catch this, I'm doing a little mini drop if I don't catch you, right? It's down there, guys, mini drop. Throw it even farther in a minute. All right, let's see if we can get this. I know the camera angle is just completely bad right now. I do not want this, I want the gym, I do not want Onix. Are you joking? What is this? Oh, thank you. Thank you for running away and just wasting 50 million Pokeballs. Now I've got absolutely nothing. Oh, Valor took it over. Thanks, Valor. Thanks, bros. Now I can't even drop a Pokemon in here, and I actually will. Let's go ahead and power this thing up. Let's go ahead and bring out, I got nothing. Electabuzz. Go. I gotta power up this gym. I wanna throw in some Pokemon. I gotta take this over. All that work, son. Pinsir's going down. Oh my gosh, it's not very effective. Fuck me good. All right, what do we got? What's a thunder punch? It's not even effective. Electabuzz, come on. Put in the work, man. Put in the work. One more. Uno mas. There we go. Victory. All right, next one. What is it? I didn't even look. Gyarados. Ooh, this should be easy. All right, this should be easy. Oh, no, wait, it's Dragon type. No, I forgot, what is it? I thought it was, I failed, guys, I failed you. My Thunder Punch gotta do work, though. My Thunder Punch gotta put in work. Dude, I might be able to power this up. Oh, what, you had no water types in this gym? Where's Team Valor at? They're killing me over here, man, you're killing me. Help me power this thing up, wherever Team Valor is. Help me power this up, Valor. Oh my gosh, no. No. Dude, I lost. Prestige. It's getting up there. Let me get this up. Come on. Gyarados, what? What team are they on? Oh my gosh. Oh no. This isn't good. Alright. Who do I put in? This isn't good at all. Who do I put in? Jolteon. No, Jolteon sucks. I don't have anyone to put in. I put my Snorlax away. Executor, you're going... Oh, man. You don't even have any health, and I have no more Hyper Potions. God damn. Primeape it is. I don't even know what Primeape can do, but Primeape, we're going to use it. All right, come on. Primeape, you're going ham against this Gyarados. Boom. Oh my, I did not know the types. I didn't know fighting types were weak against dragons. I did not know. I'm failing, guys, this isn't good. That Onix ruined the day. That Onix simply just ruined the day. At least get through the Gyarados. I need to get some, that was annihilation and a half, man. I can't even get through the Gyarados, are you joking? Come on! Speed! Victory! Okay, at least got the Gyarados down. What are you gonna fight? I have nothing here. Is it my invisible prime? Okay. I lost. I at least got level 3! Yes! Alright, let's power this up. Throw in a bad boy. Equip, son. Who the hell do I put in here? Jolteon, go. Go get him, Jolteon. You powered up. So, we've taken over 3 gyms now. Let's go ahead and check out my Pokemon, my squad. We've got three gyms. We've got Snorlax, Arcanine, as well as Jolteon in a gym right now. We're gonna go ahead and see if we can find some more Pokemon and hatch these eggs. We gotta get that Porygon today. All right, very positive. This is a 2K egg. One's about to hatch. Very positive it's a 2K egg because it was 0.4 kilometers away. And of course, completely useless. But it's okay, I'll take the candies. It's another bad day. Wait, another bad day with onyxes. Gonna have to see if we can get this one. I've caught one thus far. And it was in between a gym. What is up with onyxes, man? They're just the Pokeball wasters. They're just Pokeball wasters, man. They just run away every single time. They're lucky I've got two now. But I'm not too sure. There's tons of cars driving around, guys, so it's very hard to vlog and record all these Pokestops. So I'm just not really recording any of the Pokestops. I'm recording the egg hatching, and we're definitely gonna have a 5K pretty soon. There's an Abra, and I would love to get that Abra. But when it comes to these onyxes, goddamn, son, you guys can GTFO. So we're gonna end off the day as these last two 5K eggs are about to hatch. Let's go ahead and check them out really quick. First of all, I want to go ahead and show you guys, I do have those three gyms still. My Snorlax, Arcanine, and Jolteon are putting in that work for Team Valor. We got three gyms holding down right now. And we are on some beautiful landscape here of grass, as you guys can see. And there's a concert going on back there, and that's where I'm about to head over to. So if I find anything rare, of course, I'll go ahead and show you guys if I can, but I'm gonna have to save this last 7% of battery. Let's go ahead and get this first 5K egg out of the way. Again, we are going for Porygon, my sons. Oh! It's not nowhere near a Porygon. But do I have enough candies? 13 candies, 73. Pretty close to getting my second Nidoqueen. And here it comes, the second 5K egg. Let's go ahead and check this one out. Come on, Porygon. You're the only one I'm going for right now. Oddish. Really, man? I need Porygon. That's all I want. All right, how many candies did I get, though? I'll take that. 19 candies. We're at 39. 616 CP on that Oddish. We do get a Growlithe in the area, but not too much. Let's go ahead and check them out. First of all, my experience points ain't too far from level 74. I mean, 24. I'm talking about 74, son. We do got those three Pokemon still hitting it up in the gyms. We got three 5K eggs. One's 1 kilometer away from hatching. Let's go ahead and see if we can incubate these last two eggs as well. I believe I can. So let's go ahead and start incubation process. And I do have one use left on these incubators. Again, I do not have that much money, so I cannot afford Pokecoins, but hopefully these gyms are going to be able to cook me up with some more Pokecoin cash. Because we do got three right now. We were able to get 30 coins out of that and 1500 Stardust. Didn't think I would get any more gyms. And we do have one more Pokemon that just vibrated on the screen. Never mind, that was an email. So I'm going to go ahead and grab some Pokestops while I'm here. Again, I have now... Now the phone's done, so I'm going to stop the recording, but for now... We will be back, so stay tuned. Finally, time to recustomize my avatar. We are gonna finally mess around with it. I really don't know if there's much for me to do, but skin color wise, I mean, that's what I was at, and I don't want to change it skin color wise. Hair color wise, I really like the blue and the purple. If they had a red color hair, I would choose it for Valor. I cannot choose the blue because that's Team Mystic hair. I have to stay with the goddamn blonde, I guess, so I haven't changed anything yet. Eye color, blue was my eye color. I could go with this one instead, which is the one right before the green, which is a mix of blue and green. So I guess I changed something thus far. Hat style, there's a Team Valor hat. I guess I can get away from the Instinct hat. So let's go ahead and swag it up with the Valor. We got Instinct, Mystic, Valor, and Swag. I'm staying with my Swag. We've got Valor and Swag. We got Valor and Swag. I'm going with the dark one this time. I had the lighter color. I'm going with the darker color on the panties.
And then the boots, my shoes, the kicks. There's Valor. I gotta stay with the all orange crew, man. I really love the orange. Fuck! I just changed it from male to female and it just fucking changed everything. Alright, well, we gotta redo it now. Alright, skin color. Boom. No. It was... Yeah, that's the albino. Okay, I'm gonna go with that one. Eye color. I remember I changed it to the bluish green. The teal-y color. The hazel color. They don't have it? Are you joking? What the fuck is this? Oh, this, I'm doing hair. Alright, we're going back to blonde. Now we got the... Okay, there we go. It's already there. We got the swag cap. I'm gonna stick with the orange cap. We're gonna stick with the orange on that one. We are gonna go with the light version as well as we had before. Orange sneakers as well as... I mean, that's pretty cool. That's cool too, but it's fucking green. I don't want green. I guess I'm going with that. So, there you have it. Eye color changed. That's it. That's it.
Alrighty, everybody. We've got nothing in the gym at the moment, so we got no gym takeovers. Sadly, Squad Valor got taken away last night. And then we are also trying to hatch some eggs. Of course, Porygon is still the go-to right now. We're back at it again. Just basically going to walk around and see if we can catch any cool Pokemon. Go ahead and get some Pokestop action in. And you name it. Basically, I'm by my house right now. So not too far, not too much to do here. As you guys can see, it's Nidorans and Spearows. So I definitely don't want any of those. But you never know. There is the occasional super duper coolness that comes out of nowhere sometimes now. It's goddamn windy, so hopefully something's brewing. But for now, we're just hatching eggs. Hopefully we can get that Porygon out of the 5K. But other than that, I'm just going to walk around and see if we can hatch these eggs pretty much. If I find anything cool, I'll bring you guys back to it. But for now, let's get to it. All right. I finally arrived where I wanted to go to get the Pokestop, and I did catch a couple Pokemon on the way, but the first of the few 5K eggs that I've got left remaining, let's go ahead and unhatch the first one. Porygon, come on. It's a Goldeen. Do I have a Goldeen? Yeah, I have a Goldeen. I have a Seeking, actually, as well. How much candy, though? We got 20 candies. Oh, snap. 541 Goldeen. Looks like we about to get a baller Seeking pretty damn soon. And I'm going to go ahead and show you guys, recap you guys on what I just did on the way here. I got a bunch of trash Pokemon, but we got them, and I will be able to evolve quite a few as well. Let me see where it was. I can look at my journal. I know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so, perfect. Starting off with the Cubone at 405, we got a Nidorina at 434, Nidoran, Spearow, Nidoran, Rhyhorn, Growlithe, Sandshrew, Rattata, and that just got that Goldeen out of the egg. We do have a couple more eggs, and they will probably hatch on the way home, so hopefully we can get those. And then there is a gym being fought here. It was level 3 when I was walking here, but someone has just got it down to level 1 and is putting in the work. And then across the street, hashtag Team Valor owning it up over here. We've got a gym as well, and it is, I believe, level 3 still. Yes, with an Arcanine, Blastoise, as well as a 2058 Lapras. So that gym is doing great over there. Hopefully I can get this gym from Team Instinct over to Team Valor. We do gotta move a little bit closer to the gym right now, so let's go ahead and do that. As you guys just saw, I took over the gym. Sadly, a lot of my Pokemon have been injured from a lot of battling lately, and I do not have that many Hyper Potions, so hopefully these Pokestops can get them for me. But for now, our gym battling days are over for a little bit, but we do got a level 2 gym with my 1143 Golbat. Not strong, but it's decent enough. But we do have another gym on the other side for Team Valor, and it is... clicked the wrong gym. It is level 3, and it does have 3 Pokemon in it already, an Arcanine, the Blastoise, and the Lapras, but it is very, very close. They're only 9 points away from level 4. So I'm going to go ahead and throw some weak Pokemon. Hopefully we can take out the Arcanine. Yes, I'll lose some more Pokemon, but oh well. We're going to go ahead and try to take that gym over as well. I believe it's 2K egg this time, so hopefully we can get a starter Pokemon out of this one. Let's see what we've gotten.
Magikarp, I'll take it. Let's see if we get some candies, son. What if it's a lot of candies? Oh man, really? Only 8 candies? They got 147. Goddamn, Gyarados. Why do you have to be so far away, son? Alright, next one. We got another egg that should be hatching, and it is. It is another 2K egg, and then I believe all the rest are 5K eggs. So hopefully this one's good. Again, I want a starter Pokemon out of my fucking Geodude. Are you joking? You better be having a lot of candies, bro. 6. Really? 6? And it's extra small, and it's bad? That's even worse. What's next? What's next on the list with these egg hatchings? We got 3 out of 9 eggs. One is 0.6, and the other two are 1.2 away. So we are going to get this walking in. We're going to hatch all 3 of these eggs today that are remaining. And then, of course, I'll be back at it again, getting more eggs, getting more potions, hitting up the Pokestops hard again in order to heal up my Pokemon so I can fight gyms again. I do have those 2 gyms that we took over back with my Golbat, and I ended up throwing in some really bad Gloom in the other one because I lost so many Pokemon trying to take over that Arcanine. It was really shameful. I have so many Pokemon that are, like, completely done. So I need a lot of hyper potions. Hopefully we can get those soon. Nothing really good in our area right now, and we are almost at level 24. Level 24 would be nice to hit. And yeah, for now, let's go ahead and keep on with the journey. Our eggs should be hatching soon, and once our eggs hatch, I'll be heading out for the night, and I will continue with you guys soon.
All right, everybody. The sun's in the way. Fuck it. Oh well. We're not wasting any time with this one. There is an Ivysaur on our list, and I do not care what I find anymore. Hopefully my eggs do not hatch in the meantime. Hopefully they hatch after I find this thing. No Pokevision. Freaking nearby list sucks. And it is 4th on my list right now, so it's the 4th closest thing to me, but you know how far that can be. And hopefully we can find it, and hopefully we can get this Ivysaur, because as you guys can see, I don't have one, but I do have a Bulbasaur, and I have a lot of Bulbasaur candies, but I do not have enough. I have like 23 or 24, just enough to evolve into an Ivysaur. But it'll be great to catch an Ivysaur so I can save those candies for a Venusaur. What did we just find? We just spotted something. It is a Cubone. God damn it. Let's get to it. Alright, sadly we lost Ivysaur. I mean, I got close to it, I got it up to my top 3 on my nearby list, and then it just disappeared. So I'm assuming I was going in the correct way, but the timer of the actual Pokemon ended up going down to 0, I'm assuming, because we no longer have it on our nearby list. So that absolutely sucks. Niantic, you gotta fix this nearby shit, because it's fucking me up hard over here, son. Alright, hold up, Ivysaur just out of nowhere appeared from nowhere to first on my nearby list, and it has to be in this place, dude. It's a perfect spot for Ivysaur to be in, and it just went from near. How does it go from nothing to first? This nearby list is completely messed up. Oh no, can't see on my phone anymore. Can't see it. All right, there we go. We gotta find this Ivysaur, man. It's not even saying if it's getting closer, farther away. At least get farther away on my nearby list if I'm walking away from it, so I know I have to go backwards. Come on, Niantic, fix this. It's killing me. Walking everywhere physically possible for this Ivysaur, and it is absolutely 0 to be found. I don't know where it is. I'm going up this super steep hill right now, and I'm putting in all my effort and work into finding this Ivysaur. There's also a Fearow and an Eevee that's pretty damn decent, as well as an Oddish. I'll take anything right now, but this Ivysaur is what I'm really going for. I can't find it, and goddamn, am I putting in the work right now, son. Hopefully this egg, we have 3 5K eggs that we're going to hatch before we call it a day. And one of them is very close, so we're going for Porygon. Hopefully Porygon comes out of one of these 3 eggs. If not, the day's not over, man. We got Ivysaur. We just need Ivysaur. Alright, now we're going downhill. Where's this egg at? Where's this egg at though? Should be hatching like within 2 seconds. 5K out of 5K. You gonna hatch though, bro? Look at that. 4.98, and it's not hatching. Not hatching, son. An Ivysaur. I don't know what's going on with it. There's one more area I think I can walk to, but it doesn't move on my nearby list, which is a complete troll and a half by Niantic right now. And it's been more than 15 minutes, so it should have despawned as well.
So I have no clue where it is, why it's even here anymore. Because again, it should have despawned. And yeah, it's just trolling the hell out of me, making me walk. But it's getting me these eggs to hatch. So I don't know what's going on with these eggs either. I've walked my 0.02 kilometers already. Here we go. 5K egg. Porygon. 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 Come on. Come on. Come on. Horsey. God. I got two more eggs. Gotta get that Porygon in, son. 17 candies. It doesn't really matter. I need this Ivysaur, son. I need this Ivysaur. Alright, I have no clue what's going on here. Biggest troll of all times. It's still on my list. And it's been a well over 20 minutes. I have no clue what is this. But, I quit. Ivysaur has just been sitting on my top of the list. I found Pokemon that don't even exist on my nearby list. So this nearby list is junk. And Ivysaur is just sitting there on top, chilling, killing. And I'm going to head on home. I got two eggs that are going to hatch before I head home. And if we do not get Porygon, today was a complete fail. Actually, no, it wasn't. We actually got a lot of really trash Pokemon and a lot of candies, so we can evolve a lot of these Pokemon as well, which was a very positive out of this day. Always got to think about the positives, but this Ivysaur killed it. And sadly, we were not able to get him. And yeah, that's okay. Got a lot of Pokemon, a lot of trashers that I can evolve. And then what else do we got? We got two eggs left, so hopefully we can hatch them shortly. So go ahead and check out what they are at on the KM list. They're both at 4.9, which is pretty decent. 4.87, so we got another 0.1 kilometers to go, so let's go ahead and knock that out of the park. And I'm actually gonna go ahead and cut into a different section of this community, and hopefully we can cheat it off this way, getting this Ivysaur out if we can. But if not, oh well. I'll see you guys in a little bit. Required distance to hatch these eggs, but okay, I will take it. We've got Ivysaur still on the list, as you guys barely saw. We've got two 5K eggs. Again, we're going for Porygon, Machop. I'll take candies. I'll take candies. 1844. Not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. We got one more egg to go, and hopefully we can get Porygon. This is our last opportunity for the day. Got zero eggs left, and if we do not get them here, I'm going to basically be upset for the rest of the... Oh! Grimer. I will take Grimer. We getting zero Grimers where we live, son. Oh, what's the candy at? 19 candies at a 50. That's extra. I don't care. It's extra small, pretty decent CP. We got a Grimer. Way to end this one off. And guess what would be better? If we can get this Ivysaur. So let's head on home. I hope you guys enjoyed the vlog. If we do find Ivysaur, I will definitely, of course, show you. But I really doubt he's even here because it's been way too long. He should have despawned a long time ago. But I just want to say thank you very much for tuning in. And let's continue with our PokeVlog adventures. What's up, everybody? What's goody? And I just thought I would go ahead and end this vlog off with some evolving of our Pokemon. We do have it in number mode. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and evolve a couple Pokemon today. And the reason why we're evolving these Pokemon is because they are going to, most of them are going to be higher CP than the ones that I currently have of. And I have double of those Pokemon as well. Caterpie, I do have enough candies to evolve him. Same with Weedle, same with Pidgey, but I'm holding off for something a little bit stronger. And my Metapod is pretty damn strong, so I'm waiting for actually enough candies to evolve him to Butterfree. But some of these Pokemon, for example, my Spearow, my 374 Spearow should be higher than this Fearow. Let's go ahead and look at the circle on the Fearow. It is about 75%, while the Spearow is much stronger. It is extra small, but we do have plenty of candies, so we are going to go ahead and start off with evolving our Spearow, which should be more powerful than our Fearow, and hopefully it gets rid of the extra small attribute. So let's go ahead and check this one out. Come on, bad boy. And we're getting some experience points in here as well, getting our way closer to level 24. We got a brand new Fearow to the club, to the crew. Go ahead and check them out. What's the CP at?
What's that CP at though? 1008 CP. Over 90% full on that one. We are going to go get rid of our 827 in order to get some more candies, and hopefully we can go ahead and evolve another Spearow that will eventually be higher than that one, or just go ahead and power up that. I do have enough Ekans candies to evolve my Ekans, but my Arbok is pretty damn legit strong, and there's really no other Ekans that is going to be more powerful than this one. I do want to go ahead and evolve my Nidoran. I'm actually saving it. I was saving my candies on a Nidorina in order to evolve that on this Nidoqueen. The Nidoqueen is at 852, and it is a very poor CP Nidoqueen. I do have a Nidorina that is much more powerful than my Nidoqueen CP-wise, but I do have 100 candies almost. I'm two away. I'm going to go ahead and evolve this 494 Nidoran, which should evolve into something more powerful than the Nidorina, and if I am correct, then I'm going to have a much more stronger Nidoqueen once I get 100 Nidoran female candies. So hopefully this Nidorine, hopefully this Nidorina is stronger than the current one that I have, and it really should be CP-wise. So let's go ahead and check this one out. It is 803, and my other one was at 707, so it is roughly about 100 stronger. So that is very positive. So we're going to go ahead and drop this Nidorina, give us more candies, and we only need about, let's go ahead, we got 25 more candies to go until we can get a more powerful Nidoqueen. I can evolve my Clefairy and my Jigglypuff, I know that right off the bat, but I am waiting for an extra Clefairy and Jigglypuff right now. What else do we got? Oh, this Diglett. This Diglett's going to be more powerful than this Dugtrio. I already know that. This Diglett is actually pretty strong. It is in within the 90% range on its CP chart. So let's go ahead and get this evolution out of the way as well. And then we're going to go ahead and remove our other Dugtrio. Again, my goal in this game is to capture all the Pokemon. But you get multiples of each Pokemon, so my goal is also to have the most powerful CP of each individual of the higher evolution chain. So, for example, I want a very high CP Dugtrio. So, what do I got? A 667, which is more powerful than the 573. So let's go ahead and get rid of the 573. I was correct on that one. So far, so good. Not too shabby today. We got me nothing there. We've got nothing there. That Bellsprout is already powerful than the Weeping Bell, so you know what's happening with that bad boy over there. Hopefully I can evolve my Rapidash soon. As you guys can see, the Slowpokes are much more powerful than the Slowbro as well, too. Do we got any more evolutions on here? All my doubles are the evolutions, and I do... Oh, yes, there is a Rhyhorn evolution as well, and a Goldeen, and nothing else. All my double Pokemon that I kept, I've already went through and sorted them out. All of my double Pokemon are the ones that I wanted to evolve today. So I've got a new Rhydon for the crew. Should be more powerful than the 1160 Rhydon. It's got that extra large, so... Ah, no. My bad. There we go. Evolve this bad boy. This Rhyhorn is going to be evolving into a Rhydon. Hopefully this Rhydon has much more powerful CP than the already powerful Rhydon on my crew. And it definitely should. I've already checked out all the charts and everything. I've done the calculations, which is why I kept these Pokemon up doubles. So when we get straight into this video, I know which Pokemons I need to evolve. We got a brand new Rhydon for the crew. 1200. Oof, 1183, and it kept the XL, which is very nice. The 1160 is going to be gone. And let's go ahead and transfer this one. Just want to make sure I have enough candies for later action and later usage. And I only want one of each Pokemon. That's just how I am, an OCD like that. 541 Goldeen is going to be more powerful than this 928 Seeking. And this is our last evolution for the video, for the episode. And I just want to say thank you very much for tuning in, everybody. Don't forget to check out the description box down below. Follow me on social media. Check out the giveaway down below and my sponsorships. If you have any questions, comment down below. This is the last evolution. More powerful than my other Seeking, please. Let's see what we've got, son. Let's see what we've got. What do we got? Go! Yes! 1155, son. Much more powerful than this Seeking. Peace out, Seeking. This 928. And let's go ahead and see. I doubt any of those made my top six, but we're going to go ahead and check them out anyways. Let's see what my top six is. My top six on combat power, Brodies. My top six on combat power, Brodies. Oh, my phone's hating life right now. It's so messy. The screen is so messy. Alright, yeah, my top six is still the same. But that Rhydon's getting in there. That Rhydon got pretty close. But I just want to say again, thank you very much for tuning in. For the win, Itachi is...